Now, to train yourself for balance, purposely do this. Every time you have a thought, think to yourself, oh, I'm having a particular thought. And then purposely synchronize that thought with Mother Nature around you. So, one thought, one natural sign. And if you find yourself having multiple thoughts run right after the other, just quickly, well, you ground yourself. And that'll stop that rush of thoughts. Ground yourself by looking at your arm. Purposely look at the ceiling. Look at your toe. Look at something in Mother Nature, something that's of the body. So if you purposely ground yourself, so now we have a brand new phrase called purposely grounding ourselves. Purposely matching our spirit with the body. Because all thought is just pure spirit. So, once again, if you have thoughts that are just running off one after the other, one after another, one after another, purposely say to yourself, whoa, I have to ground myself. I have to give every thought needs a body. Ah, there it is. Every thought wants a body. So let's practice. Ah, now I'm actually purposely keeping myself grounded. Ah, I'm purposely grounding myself. So remember, grounding is just another word for observing my surroundings. This here is Pepper the cat. I'm purposely paying attention to him. And that keeps my thoughts from going into the rushing rapids of ego. That's the rushing rapids of ego. Thoughts, one after the other. Haste, anxiety, worry. If I keep myself grounded, purposely ground myself, whoa, I'm a body. I have a body here too. I'm not just 100% thought. I'm a body. I'm 50% thought, 50% body. Ah. Yes. Ah. And that brings an instant that starts to build a relaxation. Now you can actually close your eyes now. Now when your eyes are closed, you have thoughts too, but how do you ground yourself? How do you look at Mother Nature when your eyes are closed? Well, focus on the back of your eyelids. Now you have black that you're looking at. And in that black, you have various shapes of light. They can be splotches, swirls, the shapes of many stars. And if you look for a amount of time in synchronization with your thoughts, you can actually start to see pictures forming in the back of your eyelids. How many have ever had that happen before? Raise your hands. How many of you have ever had pictures form on the backs of your eyelids? Raise your hands. Yes, see? It's a common thing that happens to all of us. There's a plane that's going by in the air over the house. I hear it. It's Mother Nature. To me, that's a natural sign of confirmation. It's Mother Nature telling me, yes, you're on the right path. I look outside and I can see a branch to a tree flapping in the breeze. At the sun reflecting off the green leaf, making it shiny, glittery. Mother Nature's natural signs. There's a shadow behind me, look at that. That's a natural sign being projected onto a manufactured sign. The wall is manufactured, Mother Nature. The shadow is real. This hand is real. It's moving. Look at that. Two shadows interacting. The yawn, Mother Nature, saying, ah, you're entering into a relaxed state. Yes, this is good. To be here in the present moment of now, consistently. Yes, we can maintain these. We can close our eyes. Now we just shifted to black screen before our eyes. And so we can observe our thoughts. And our thoughts might even just be thoughts of just focusing on the back of our eyelids. My Adam's apple needed to swallow. Some people call that a knot in the throat. A knot in the throat can be a sign of dehydration. It could be a sign of pride. Or it could be just a sign of the need to swallow saliva that builds up in the mouth. There's no shame of having to have a knot in your throat. Unless, of course, you're feeling shameful or you're feeling guilty. When people go on the stands for a testimony before a jury or before a judge, they might often get a knot in their throat if they're lying. Or they could be telling the truth and also have the same knot. But the knot is just a sign of uncomfortableness. They're shy. When you feel shy, your mouth gets dry sometimes. And so that's a sign of dehydration. But remember to stay centered and stay balanced. You're watching the thoughts. Right now, my thoughts are just a clear mind. I'm having a clear mind right now because I'm purposely staying grounded. So my mind is staying clean and clear. I'm focused on the signs of Mother Nature. Right now, I'm looking at a natural sign, which is the blackness on the back of my eyelids. And I can see some flashes of light. Blur, depending on where I move my head. Ah, there's a light. I just looked at the light because I have a light shining at me. I had my knee in the way. It was in the way. I moved my knee and all of a sudden, flash. Ah, the darkness started turning orange, kind of, because it's the color of light. This is good. Maintaining a balance. I don't have to work a job. I can just sit here all day and do nothing. This house that I have, I hold title to it. And right now I'm in the process of accessing the ATM card so I can use that to purchase more utilities, more luxuries in life, necessities of life like food, clothing, new socks, laundry materials. all the different things that life has to offer that are here for our enjoyment. So remember, the purpose of this video was how to purposely ground ourselves when we get lost in the river or the rushing rapids of thought. And those rushing rapids of thought are looking to, they form from the cerebellum, which is the animal brain, which is the female side of us, female side of our brain. The Most High is the cerebrum. It's the male side of our brain. It represents cause. The animal brain represents effect. The male brain represents thought. The female brain represents manifestation. The male brain represents fire. The female brain represents water. Many names, the same thing. So, you can think on these things, and you can purposely ground yourself with understanding, wisdom, and knowledge, all flowing from the source of love. And you can I can open my eyes again and keep myself grounded by purposely making sure that my eyes are connecting with my surroundings. Grounding. It's like walking out in the backyard barefoot on the ground. You ground yourself on the ground with your bare feet. So grounding. So now we have a brand new word for being aware of our surroundings and Mother Nature. It's called being grounded. When you're grounded, you're not lost in the pure spirit, which is thought. That's the invisible realm. And that can be connected to the ego. That can be just a circumstance of total confusion, anxiety, which is all rooted in fear. Think on these things. Ta-ta.